Hi, do you know how goods are carried from China to Europe? Most cargo is shipped between two busiest ports, Shanghai and Rotterdam. The vast majority of ships sails through southern waters, sticking to the red route. However, there is another option. The other blue route runs through Arctic waters. You might think that the southern route is shorter, but that's not the case. We need to pause and ponder to think about this. Imagine our Earth as big orange that could be divided into wedges. If you try to unwrap it, you would get a flat surface formed by the top sides of these wedges. Let's take one of those and stretch it a little. The boundaries of this figure are called meridians. If you measure the horizontal distance between them, you will see that it reaches maximum near the equator and it approaches zero when going to the poles. So the northern route becomes shorter. Now let's return to our map and continue comparing the routes. Despite the gain in distance, the northern route has several drawbacks because it passes through icy waters. So, most of ships opt for Suez Canal route. Researchers usually compare the two options in terms of total cost that consists of insurance cost, maintenance cost, capital cost, tariff, cost connected with visiting ports, crew and administration cost, and fuel cost, which is the largest. In order to calculate them, we need to use real data from the industry. Ship characteristics affect tariffs, since larger ships are charged more and they are more expensive to build. Distance, time spent in port and on maintenance, are directly connected with the time of one voyage, which in turn affects the possible number of voyages per year and tariff and port costs again. Sailing speed plays a major role here. It influences time parameters and fuel consumption. However, fuel cost is mostly governed by fuel price, which usually varies a lot. Until this moment, it was a typical scheme for the calculation of marine shipping costs. Did you notice that I intentionally leave the space for some other parameters? This is what distinguishes my work from the rest and allows making an accurate cost estimate. These parameters are ice class, ice conditions, and ice thickness. Ships with higher ice classes are more reliable and expensive, but they can sail in Arctic independently, consuming more fuel. Lighter ice conditions allow decreasing the tariffs for sailing in the Northern Sea route. Finally, if ice thickness is high, the ship has to decrease its speed. Let me briefly show some examples. There is a typical dependence between a ship's price and its ice class on the left, and the dependence between ice thickness and ship's speed on the right. After playing with parameters, I'm ready to present typical results. I compare the average voyage cost for a ship sailing in Suez Canal route with the same cost for a ship that uses Northern Sea route during summer and Suez Canal route in the rest of the year. Here I'm analyzing how the results change depending on ice class. No wonder that Suez Canal route is represented by a straight line, since it doesn't require ice protected ship. The situation becomes more interesting for Northern Sea route. Ships without ice protection are prohibitively expensive, since they have to pay large tariffs for icebreaker escort. As you can see, Northern Sea route is only feasible for ice protected ships. It happens because they have lower tariffs. The first ice class is the cheapest one. However, it's quite risky because it's the least prepared ice class. I wouldn't recommend it, since the cost for ice classes between 1 and 5 doesn't change much. For the next ice classes, the cost for Northern Sea route is increasing because these ships are really expensive. In essence, they're almost like icebreakers. I should note that I used lines only to show the dynamics. Of course, this dependency is discrete. I tried to explain the essence of my research in simple and visual language. In fact, there is a bunch of details here. If you're interested in them, please read the full version of my paper. I left the link in the description. Thank you for watching this video. After a while, I will post the results of my further research on the topic. The next episode will be more visually oriented. So, stay tuned!